So, a couple of months ago, I started preparing for Comic-Con, which actually happened last weekend, but we'll talk about that more later. And I had to make a lot of product designs for it. I knew I had a lot of space on the table that I needed to fill up, so I had to fill it somehow. I made all these drawings and then I had to choose which ones to turn into products and which ones weren't gonna be anything. I had a lot of cute, like my usual stuff, cute animals and stuff, and I knew those were going to sell well. And I had a couple of designs that I thought weren't that suitable to turn into products. There was one design in particular that I really liked. It was a design with a couple of ladies with different body types. They were like cuddling, embracing each other. And with that piece, I wanted to firstly represent more different body types. And I also wanted to represent like the lesbian community, where, or in general, like the LGBTQ plus community, where it's okay to love someone of the same gender or to love someone who is not like the typical hetero relationship. And I really felt like for the first time I accomplished that with that piece. But I didn't know if it was something that would be like good to put on a product design. So I did a YouTube poll. I took a couple of my designs and I put them in a poll to see if people wanted to have products of them or if they didn't want products of them. And it looked like my suspicions were correct. People didn't want that particular design of mine. So I ordered it because I really liked it and I was really feeling like it showed something that I wanted to convey with my art that I wasn't doing in my other work. So it was really important to me. So I wanted to buy it even though it might not be as popular as my other designs. So fast forward to last weekend, Comic-Con arrived. So I took my notebooks, the ones with the cute animals that I had, and this one with the pretty ladies with different body types. And this design wasn't my best-selling design, but it sold okay. It sold fairly well. The difference was in the way that my customers treated the different designs. Whenever I would sell my cute drawings, of course, people would be happy with them. They would think they're very cute. But whenever I sold one of my notebooks with this design on it, the people who got it would always be talking more about it, how they really liked it, how they loved that there was like representation of different body types, how it was really different, and that it was something special and it wasn't something they would find like in most stands. It really made me feel like my work brightened their day and that it was really meaningful. I think that as an artist, you have the choice whether you want to make something for the big masses who might already have like a lot of work to choose from, or if you want to make something for a minority group that might usually not feel included in the work that is available right now. I'm not trying to say that you can never draw cute animals or pretty girls or what you want, but I do think it's really valuable to once in a while also try to draw different things. Like, appreciate the things that make us different and try to include that into your work so more people can feel represented by the things that makes us unique. I think that's really important. After all, I feel like art is supposed to be for everyone. And there are a lot of people that don't feel included by like the majority of art that is available. So next time you make art, maybe include someone that usually can't find art that represents them.